In this video, we're going to discuss the hidden behavior. So there it is, right before us. It's all around us. It's happening right now. We can see it in front of us. Do you see it? Of course you don't. It's hidden, right? So hidden behavior is happening as we speak. And I'll let you take a guess at what's hidden in front of us as I walk around. So I've set up sort of like a museum of sorts, I guess maybe a wax museum or something, where we've got these little characters in there and we can come around and look at the individual exhibits. And they don't see us. We can see them. And they're just kind of mulling about. Now, those guys can hear us. Their hearing range is greater than the zombies. Right, so if I get really close, noise, he'll react to me. So you can tell he's not idle. It's not like I put an NPC in there and just made him idle. They're active NPCs, and they would absolutely shoot at me if they could. But they can't.
Hear that?
Right? And the way that's done is with these walls. So the walls are what are hidden. And let me show you how that works. So hidden is a global behavior, meaning you apply it someplace, not on the thing that you're trying to hide, but on something else that's going to govern the things you want to hide. And you tell it, okay, what is the name of the thing that you want to hide? And whatever that is, or anything that has that name, is going to be affected by this behavior. The only other thing you need to know is whatever it is that you name also needs to be a dynamic object. So do make sure that all of the blue brick walls or whatever it is you're hiding has physics on and is immobile. So that's really important. But beyond that, we can govern all of those anywhere in the level with this one behavior, just by naming it here. And we have two more parameters here. We have the collision mode and we have the nav mesh. So I think by now most of us are pretty familiar with collision modes. Collision is just obviously whether or not we can pass through the object. So I've got it on, so I couldn't pass through. So in this scenario, I don't want my players to be able to go into the exhibit and interact with the NPC, because once they're in there, they could get hurt. We don't want that to happen. You might also set it up to where, Necrom brought up an interesting scenario where, let's suppose there's enemies in the jungle and they can, you know, see and come through, but you don't want the player to be able to go into the jungle because that's like the edge of the map. You could do something like that as well. So collision mode keeps the player from walking through whatever it is that you have hidden. Navmesh block is kind of the other way around. Navmesh block is what stops the NPC from passing through what you've hidden. So it's kind of the other way around. The Navmesh block is going to take that Navmesh that kind of connects the two spaces and put a block along where whatever the object is hidden. So here there's basically a gap between this area and this area. There's this little hidden gap. And so the NPC doesn't know that they can walk past there. So that stops them. So in Necrom's scenario, where you want NPCs to come in from this outside area, but you don't want the player to go out, you would turn on collision and then off nav mesh, and then the NPC would be able to come through. Now, collision mode also seems to block ray casting, right? So let me show you what I mean by that. If I were to turn off collision mode, what's going to happen is the NPCs are now going to be able to see me because they can, they're doing the ray casting and they're seeing me, and now they can shoot at me. So even though they can't really get through because they're in Navmesh, it doesn't bother them at all. They can shoot at me. So just be aware of that. Just depending on your scenario, what you need it to be. Okay. But that's it. That's the hidden behavior and how you might use it. There's probably a million different ways you can use it. But that's the way I came up with. If you enjoyed the video or if you learned anything new, please be sure to click the like button down below. It helps me out a lot. If you're new here or if you just haven't subscribed yet, now would be a great time to do so. Would love to have you stick around. And if you'd like a notification for whenever new videos are posted, just click the bell icon down below. That's your friend there, and it's going to help you out and save the day and let you know when new videos are on their way. But that's it. Thanks so much. I appreciate every one of you, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now. Hey, don't forget, there's a written guide for every behavior, including ones I haven't yet covered on this channel. And if you want to learn some more, why don't you check out this video next.